Hundreds of displaced victims of Olokoonla town via Ogombo village in the Tiusoloku government area of Lagos State stormed the Lagos Island residence of the former Lagos State governor Bola Tinubu to protest 1 month of homelessness brought about by an illegal demolition by the state government.
They just come one day. They don't even notice of before. They tell one just see the OC as a capricor. Four. They start to demolish the house. That's the one day for house. Some people die inside the house.
Ati fe to bi ose merin so se marun sin. A ma jijade laaro owo caterpillar to wa mi la jijade si. Ti won bere si ni wo gbogbo ile wa. Ko ti a de n fe lowo ijoba ni pe ko gba wa ko wa ran wa lowo. Nitori pe gbogbo ru nkan be yen ko gbodo ololasan.
One of the protesters said he had nowhere to lay his head since the exercise.
We'll stay outside, we'll not get house again.
Latin Bano Boba, your woman, me, Taban Balobres, Nisusi, you told me one wall here, mommy, belly, or mommy, one bed, one wall here, so Taban Baloma, and Susi, but you are one more to one, your woman, Latin Journal.
Displaced victims say two persons died 3 days ago due to the torture they allegedly received from the soldiers. One of the protesters, 70 years old, Suebatu Ayedogbon, said the exercise had almost reduced her family to beggars. The victim staged a peaceful protest at the entrance of Tinubu's residence located at Burdelon to register their plight.
You are a police officer, you cannot address us. On that same day, the army brutalized the police official. Yes. It is not a police duty to address us. Let the official from his desk address our issue.
Victim's lawyer, Oladotun Hassan.
But we want clarification. We want his intervention. And we want an absolute solution to the issue of demolition in Lagos State, especially when the demolition are in contravention of extant laws of Nigeria. And we believe that we own sovereignty, and sovereignty belongs to the people. And whatever we need to know, we want Ashwaju to please come out and address us. We have gone to the governor refused our entrance. We have gone to the speaker, we are here to get a response from them. But we believe that if Ashwaju is available, he is very, very fundamentally a person that can give us solution as far as our plight is concerned. Led by officials of Lagos State Government in person of Bodia Guru and some officials of Lagos State Government from the Lagos State Ministry of Physical Planning and Urban Development, we believe that the atrocities committed on the 16th of December is unlawful. We believe that 48 hours in any democratic system is a disgrace to democracy. We believe that whatever expression from the government angle without recourse to the people's plight, because we owe it a duty of care that the government of Lagos State have done something that is inimical and a flagrant disregard to fundamental human rights of the people of Olokoonla community in Itiosa, Lagos. And that is why we have come to express our view. That is why we believe that the whole world must know what the plight of the people are. And the people's plight is that they demolish over 200 buildings worth 15 billion naira within 24 hours. Why? That is the question that is being placed on our mind. And these atrocities are being committed in the name of Ashwaju Bola Ahmed Tinubu.
Addressing the protesters, an aide to the former governor, Tunde Rahman.
And speak with the appropriate authorities to deal with what you have presented. So you be rest assured that Ashwaju Tinubu, like you said, is a man of peace, a progressive leader.
Thank you very much.
And he knows that you have come here with genuine grievances. He will look at them on their own merit, and then we'll get back.
And it's meeting with you next week.
Next week.
Many of the victims claim to have been brutalized while trying to retrieve their property. These protesters claim they were displaced on December 16, 2016, when some armed military men in company of some officials of the Lagos State Ministry of Physical Planning and Urban Development demolished about 200 buildings valued at 15 billion naira.